Here they are, two packages. This one from Spain and this obviously from the US. This is my first pair of StockX. Really excited about these. Been trying to get these for a good 8 or 9 months now. This thing just recently dropped. Probably gonna do this one first because this is more recent than this one. So let's pack it all in and let's go home. I just noticed I have to open this up so it's gonna fit into my backpack. So here we go. Can only carry one box on my carrying thing. Yeah, this is an Adidas. Oh, no reveal. ZX 8000. This is gonna be coming first anyway, so I can show these. Wee. Well, no review for this one. There are spots throughout the shoe. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 spots on the shoe, and the heel tabs are cut differently. Left one is lower than the other one. That's a piece of shit. So it's just gonna be the two of us, right? The other one is going back and you're coming home. I hope you're gonna be in a better condition. I'm super disappointed by the Adidas. Thought it would be a lot better. There are at least 10 spots of glue on the upper throughout the shoe. Just crap. I mean, the heel is not cut right. Toe box not that exciting either, so I'm gonna keep it. Still thinking if I should do a review at all, but if stuff like that happens, if I'm too much disappointed, I don't even have any fun doing a review anymore, because the excitement is just gone. And too much negativity. I don't want negativity, so think about it.
Here it is, my latest pickup in the 9 on X series. This is the New Balance 993 in the GL colorways. It took me forever to get one of these, and it took me forever to complete this video. I think I bought this in the summertime around July. I think came end of July or something, and that's 2 months ago. We have November now, start of November. And these, like I said, took me also forever to find. I was eyeing them for a while. I started looking around October, November of last year, and they were cheap on eBay. They were to be had on Joe's New Balance outlet on eBay. And around Christmas, they were around 100 euros and never picked them up. And I'm really, really bummed out that I didn't. But at that time, I didn't have any money for them. I put my money onto other things. And I was hoping that the price would remain so low, but it didn't. In the new year, they went up and went up and went up. And then COVID-19 came along and the shipping costs also exploded. They went from $20 to $40. And in the end, I would have had to pay 240 euros, and that was just not worth it to me. So in the summertime, my size appeared on StockX. This is the first pair I bought on StockX. And for a decent price, actually, I think around 180 euros, I think, with shipping and everything and the fees, I paid 185. So that's totally fine in my book. And the thing is, now they pulled them off of the eBay platform completely. I'm not sure if they're going to release them in Europe as a general release, but now it's even more difficult to pick them up. So I'm really, really glad that I have been able to add these to the collection. Maybe you know that I'm trying to complete the 9NX series, and this is a step forward with that project, so I'm very happy. And it is actually pretty similar to the design of the 992. They are definitely brothers from the same mother, and the differences are very subtle, but they're there and they're noticeable. Both of them are very comfortable. I think this one here really fits true to size, as where the 992, you could debate if you go down half size or go true to size. I think generally the 992 fits true to size as well, just slightly larger, but this one definitely is true to size. Well, I think this looks a little bit less like a dad shoe because it does not have that little raise here on the midsole at the heel. It is a little bit more streamlined, a little bit more straightforward, and the paneling is very, very similar as well. The colors are almost identical. Only the color here on the midsole heel section is a little different. We have a, well, more a gray gray than this little off-white gray or cream gray on the 992. Also, this little heel part is leaning towards the front, whereas on the 992, this is moving towards the back. The lacing is a little different. We have 7 lace holes instead of 6 on the 992. Also, the spacing on the laces is a little bit tighter, and they are starting more further up on the shoe, which makes this look a little longer. Also, the mudguard is a little shorter, and that makes the whole toe box appear a little longer and a little bit more pointy. I'm really liking both of them, leaning a little more towards the 993 because it's a little less looking like a dad shoe, and a little bit more sporty, if you want to call it that way. Anyway, both of them are staples, and I'm very, very happy that I've been able to add the 993 to the 99X series. I hope I'm going to be able to complete it. The 999 might be a problem because of the sizing. 12 might be too snug, and the 13 might be too big, and it's going to be very hard finding a 13 in the 999. I want to have the gray or the blue pair, so very hard. Anyway, very happy to have these finally, and I'm going to leave you with the on feed. And if you're not subscribed to the channel, then please subscribe, because it's going to help me putting out more videos like these. And if you like this video, then give me a thumbs up, and I hope you enjoy the video. I hope I'm going to see you in the next one. So thank you very much for watching. Until next time, bye-bye. Thank you.